Hello, my name is Sarah Nelson from University High School. I will be giving an oratory on how money does not lead to happiness. I am using this video for the State Quals Tournament. Imagine having as much money as Bill Gates. Imagine being able to do anything you want with that money. Would you donate it to charity or donate it to people who you think need it? Would you go buy that really nice car and house you've always wanted, or even go pay off your student loans you've been building for the last 30 years? Would this money corrupt you or make you incredibly happy? That is the big debate. The debate on how money and happiness are tied and how that can affect you as a whole. Happiness could lead to many things in life. It can create many small joys to look forward to, like children, marriage, and overall better mental health. But does money lead to happiness, and why does money have such a grip on people? Is that grip that money have on us good or bad? In ancient times, the concept of money has been a key part of society through the centuries. Money holds a sense of power and security since the concept of exchanging currency was invented. Money has occupied a very, very powerful spot in our hearts, minds, and lives of people. Some have lived and died never having had much of it, and some have literally given their lives in the legal or illegal pursuit of it, while others have lived and died with more than they could ever have spent in their lifetime and still felt they never had enough. Have you ever heard of the lady that sued McDonald's because she poured a really hot cup of coffee in her lap? Well, her story is rather simple. More than 20 years ago, a 79-year-old Stella Liebeck ordered a coffee at the McDonald's drive-thru. She spilled her coffee and was severely burned, and a year later sued McDonald's. She gained $2.9 million due to McDonald's not saying on their label that their coffee is hot. This is just a simple case of why do we need to ask why our hot coffee is hot? Just simple reasoning here. But this leads us to ask, why does money have such a huge grip on ourselves and our realities and sense of self? The idea of being able to do anything we want in the world is exhilarating, so that can lead to many people pursuing money so that they can do anything they want with their lives. Big corporate powers have shown in their past that they use their money to get what they want. This is not the morally just thing to do. People in today's lower and middle class society fight for the things they want or need. They simply just can't buy it with the imaginary money that flows around in the world. A lower income high school student has to fight tooth and nail for scholarships. They have to work their hardest to maintain the GPA so that they can get the scholarship that they need to get into the college. They often have to hold jobs and do college classes all at the same time, which proposes many challenges. Meanwhile, rich people are paying the admissions office to just let their kids in without any questions asked. In 2019, the FBI finally busted at least 50 people paying admissions officers to let their students in. Two of them were celebrities. What does this say about the United States? What does this say about the rich people in the United States? Some of them are just not right in the head. Just putting it that way. It's not okay to get away with paying off admission just so your child can go to the college they really want to go to. That just isn't right. This just begs for me to ask a rather simple question. Is money so important that it is necessary to put it in front of you, in front of everything that you have, just so your child can get into a college that they tried to get into and weren't meant to get into? Just because you have the money doesn't mean you need to force your child to do something that just isn't right for them. That isn't right. That isn't fair. And that isn't just. Money may make the world go round, but it should be the thing that determines, shouldn't be the thing that determines your future. Your future is in your own hands, not in the hands of money. So the real question is money really worth the lives we have lost for it? Throughout time, money has led to war, fights, wars, and an example could be shown in our own country. The Civil War was fought and splitting and brutally killed hundreds and thousands of people in our own country over the idea of having slaves. But that wasn't just the only reason we were fighting. We were fighting against the North and the South for having industrial and agricultural governments and systems of way of running and having their money and economy flowing around. So basically, this put the North in a pickle. The North had all the money. The South had none. They had cotton and not enough food to feed their army, and not enough weapons to use to their army's advantage, not a zilch. They were put in the disadvantage simply because of money. Money equals power, because money equals that big gun, and that big gun can take down the big evil dude. Simply putting it, there's just no fight we can win without having the money and or resources to do that. Money can buy things, and those things are what can make you happy. But can money buy forgiveness? Can money buy you back your loved one's life back? Can money let you bring those back that are dead? These are all questions that we should ask ourselves so that we can pursue what is best for us. The biggest thing I hope you take away from is that money is not what leads to happiness. Happiness is created of your own accord. Happiness is what you, as yourself, discover. Money shouldn't be the very thing, the very idea that makes you happy. That's just not right. Money should help you find your happiness. Yes, like that dream vacation you've always wanted to go on. Perfect excuse to spend money. But using money to get into an admission office, not a great excuse. Suing a company because they didn't put a warning label on a drink that's clearly going to be hot is ridiculous and just unfair and unjust. This leads me to ask, is money that big thing in your life that you put on the table and your family argues about every night? Or is it that thing in the back of your mind telling you, hey, you have a bill due next week, just a heads up, and you actually spend it wisely? My advice? Money may make the world go around, but money doesn't make your happiness go around the world. Thank you. I hope you have a wonderful night.